We have learned that the stress state of a mature point can be captured by a tensor with 9 components. Now, let's have a closer look of these 9 values. In fact, the 9 values of a stress tensor are not absolute. With a different coordinate system, the values will be different, but still can represent the same stress state. Let's have a look at this simple torsion bar problem. A pair of torsional force applied to the ends of the bar. The stress state is uniform along the axis, which means if we cut the bar at any location, the stress distribution over the cross-section will be always the same. If we pick an infinitesimal cube with position A on the bar, the stress state will only have values for x, y, and y, x components as shear stresses. We say the material is in pure shear under such torsional loads, so no normal stress value exists for the stress tensor. However, if we rotate the cube by 45 degrees and reach position B, the shear forces on the cube will be transformed to normal forces. The stress tensor will only have components for normal x and y directions. These two tensors, although they look very different, they're representing the same stress state of the chosen material point. The only difference between them is the coordinate systems they're in. Now you might wonder, why such coordinate transformation is needed? Why not just stick with one coordinate system? Well, we want the stress result to serve engineering purposes instead of just numbers without any physical meanings. Let's go back to the torsion bar problem again. In real life, if the torsion bar is made of ductile material, for example, it's made of steel, with excessive torsion load, the material will break. And you will find the failure plane will be almost perpendicular to the axis direction. This is because ductile material fail when shear stress reaches a certain value. In this case, naturally, engineers want to use a coordinate system that can reflect maximum shear stress. So we prefer to review the stress with the infinitesimal cube in position A. However, if the torsion bar is made of brittle material, for example, it's a piece of chalk or it's a concrete column, you will find the failure plane is usually 45 degrees to the axis. This is because brittle material fail when normal stress reaches a certain value. So it makes sense to evaluate stress out of brittle materials in a coordinate system that maximum normal stress value is reflected, just like position B. The coordinate transformation leads to another very important concept, principal stress. So what is principal stress and how to find them? A figurative way to describe principal stress. If we are given a stress tensor, we change the coordinate system of it in a certain way that the shear stress components become zero. And the three normal stresses left in the tensor are the principal stresses for the stress state. More specific, let's have a look at the three stress components on the top face of the infinitesimal cube. There are two shear stresses, sigma zy and sigma zx, and one normal stress, sigma zz, on it. The three stress components are represented by three vectors with directions and lengths. Now, if we do vector addition on these three vectors, we will create a new vector. Let's call it sigma p. In a reserved way, if we decompose the new vector sigma p in the x, y, and z direction, it gives back the original three stress components, right? Next, let's rotate the cube surface to a position that the face is normal to sigma p and identify a new coordinate system, x prime, y prime, and z prime. In this new coordinate system, sigma p is the only stress component and is normal to the surface. Such sigma p is the principal stress of the original stress state. Similarly, we can explain principal stresses on the other two faces. We use index 1, 2, and 3 to denote the three principal stresses. Another look at principal stress. So we start with a cube with 9 stress components to a rotated cube with 3 stress components. The tensor expressions are as shown here. For the principal stress, the three components are located along the diagonal of the tensor. Remember that although they look very different, these two stress expressions represent exactly the same stress state. The reason they look different is they're written in different coordinate systems. One is in the original x, y, z axis, the other is in the principal axis, x prime, y prime, and z prime. Another way to understand this, We know that a vector is independent of the coordinate system, right? Which means vectors' components are not the same in different coordinate systems. Same thing for a tensor. Tensor is just a high-order object compared to vector. And the principal stress is obtained at a very special coordinate system that all the off-diagonal values are zero. Now we have learned the physical interpretation of principal stress, that we can find stress surface where only normal stress exists. However, to find the principal stress for a stress tensor, what we do is not trial and error rotating the faces each time and repeating. Here, let's have a brief introduction of how principal stress is calculated mathematically. Basically, the process to find principal stress is the process to calculate the eigenvalues of a 3x3 matrix. Eigenvalue problems occur in many areas of science and engineering and in analyzing numerical methods. In fact, we will see eigenvalue problem multiple times in this course. So what is an eigenvalue problem? It's a problem with given n by n matrix A, find a scalar lambda and vector x such that Ax equals to lambda x, and lambda will be the eigenvalues and vector x will be the eigenvectors. In the problem of finding principal stress, we'll find three lambdas, which will be the three principal stress components. Correspondingly, we'll find three eigenvectors, which form the principal coordinate system. The reason that engineers are interested in finding principal stress of a body is for some materials, the state of them are determined by principal stress, just like what we discussed for the torsion bar problem. If the bar is made of brittle material, like chalk or concrete, we need the principal stress to evaluate the material condition, because brittle material typically fails in tension in normal direction.